welcome back to my channel Learn with Krishan. Today we are going to start the session number 5. In this session we will learn how to search the record and how to print it on ITL. So let us discuss the slide first. Same way we'll start the ITL and we'll open the new file and we'll type the sum of the coding which is shown in the next slide. Now here you can see import CSV as usually we are importing, then with open, this is the CSV file name. The mode is R, reading mode, new line is empty as file. Then we have given the variable name search, right? And here we are asking the value. We are asking the value where user can enter any value, right? So the file is open in a reading mode, and the same way we are going to create the writer, right? Writer is equal to csv.reader. Okay, and for traversing in a column and record we need a loop, so we are going to start for loop. This is a variable and we are going to search the data in a writer. Writer is a example.csv file. Now if you want to search the particular value, then you have to match some input. As you can see, we are asking input here, search. So we'll ask the user to enter some of the value. That value we will check it with the column number 1. Okay, if the value got match, then we are going to print this remaining values. Right, in last example when we are going to extract all the data, so there was no such type of condition. Only we are going to traverse, okay, in the CSV file by row by row and column by column, and we are simply extracting all the data. But here it is little bit different. Okay, so based on the user input you can search any kind of data. Here you can see one single condition is given by me. You can put or and you can search with the help of some other, like teacher name. You can search with the school name, you can search with the designation. Okay, not only this index number 0, you can search on index number 1, index number 2, index number 3. So here you have to write it index number. For example, if you want to search with designation, here you write it index number 3 is equal to search, and here you can ask enter the teacher designation. So the data will be filtered according to the input, and when the moment you will enter some of the values, this will find the result. If no match, then here you can see we are given the else statement and the result will come no match found. So the same thing, you have to press F5 to run the program. Now you can see I'm going to enter the ID, which is 108. If it is existing, I'll get result, otherwise the error message will come. So the data is existing in this CSV file, so we are getting our data. So this way you can easily search a data as per your requirement. Now you can see the file a little bit. I want to display some of the interactive symbols before printing or searching the data. So these things will come. Now you can see, now these things is appearing, search teacher detail using teacher ID, and we are going to enter the teacher ID. Now you can see the output is printed in this way. So this way you can easily find out any data in a CSV file. Now let's see a practical how we can do it. So first of all, you can see I'm going to create a text document. Let me start the text document, and some of the information we will write here. For example, PROTUCT product ID, comma, product name, comma, product cost. Okay, it may be a similar like a previous example. So product ID is available, product name is available, and product cost is available. So let us see. For example, example, product ID is A101, and the product name is, for example, it is a fan, and the cost is 5000. Then A102, another product, and the name is a scooter, and the cost is approximately, this is the cost. The product number 3, you can see, for example, mobile, and the cost is 25. So let's save the file, give some name to the file. For example, we'll give product product, product, and hit enter. But you can see that is saved as a text file. We have to save in a CSV file. So here, instead of txt, you can write it CSV. Right now, you can see the CSV file is available on our desktop. This we will delete it because it is not required. Alright, so once you will open this file with the help of Excel sheet, the file will look like this. You can see I'm using here Calc, so output will be a little bit different compared to the Excel sheet, but it will be same as you can see, right? So here you can see, so this type of output, this is product ID, product name, and product cost, and these are the values are available in, right? Now let us go for the IDE. So we'll start the IDE as usually we are doing. Same way you have to go to the new file, and the same thing you have to do, import CSV, right? Then you have to open the file with open. So what's your CSV file name? It is product, product product.csv, and we have to open the file in read mode as I told you last time also. Okay, and the new line is equal to, let me make it empty as file. Now first I will show you that data will be, we are going to simply extract the data only first. Okay, now writer is equal to csv dot writer, we'll open the bracket and we'll write it the variable of the file. Okay, let us have a for loop for data in writer, and let us traverse the data. We'll print the data. So let us print the value 1, as we are having 3 different values. So we'll print it here, data number 1, and we will print the last data. Okay, so you can see all the data now going to print. We are not searching anything, simply we are going to print all the data. So let us run the program. Now let us save on desktop. Okay, and give some name SE. I have given SE. Alright, so something is wrong here. Writer is equal to csv.writer. Object is not iterable. Yes, so don't be mistake, as the file is open in a reading mode, so we have to write it here, reader. So now you can see we are getting all the data, right? All the data we are getting without, okay, everything we are getting, even the heading and everything we are getting. let us see now how we can find out the particular data. So first of all, we have to ask input to the user. For example, we will give a variable name as a search, and we will ask user to input the data which is going to match. Enter product as your file name is product ID. Got it. So you can see when you will run this program, you will need to provide some product ID, right? So it is still, it is going to print all the data because there is no match with the search. So we'll have a if condition. If search is equal to data index number 0, okay, if match found, then only we have to print. So first of all, let me print a message that data found. Okay, so this type of message we can print, then we can print the remaining value. Now we have to run. Okay, so here we have to enter the first row index number 0. So as per the data, you can see the first row index number 0 is product ID. It is not A01. Okay, so let us see product product underscore ID. Now you can see we are getting all our details related to first row. All the detail is appearing here. Okay, see, all the detail is there, but we are not getting the data what we want actually, right? So for this, what we have to do, so you can see we have to go to the next row. First header we have to leave it. We need not to go for the heading, and we can leave it header. So we are going to use a header here, header, header is equal to next. Okay, where to the next? Next to the writer. And what is the writer? Writer is the CSV file, and we are going to move to the next of the heading. You understood, no? See, here this is the row number 1. Okay, so we are going to move to the next one. So let's run and check out whether it's working properly or not. What are the errors are there? Yeah, so we'll enter A101. So now you can see the data got found. It is 101 is span, and the value is 5000 rupees. You can check out in your, this is the data is existing. Now let us see the A0103. So again I'm going to run the same file. Here I'll write A103, and you can see the data got found. It is a mobile, and the amount is 25,000. Mobile and amount is 25,000. So I think it is clear to everybody. You can see this is same as we are expecting data, right? The session number 4 what we learned, and the same way, right, you can extract the data. If you don't have header, then you need not to write this thing, but if you are having the header or title of the column, then you can use this header is equal to next and the writer. Now we are going to traverse, and while traversing, if the data match, then message will be display data found, and print all this value of the particular data which you have found. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have any doubt and query, please type it in the comment box. Right, thank you for watching.